In this video, I'm going to show you how to do the reverse Lachman test for posterior cruciate ligament injuries. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. The PCL provides maximum resistance to posterior tibial translation when the knee is in 90 degrees of flexion. However, the posterior drawout test can be difficult to perform in the acutely injured knee because the patient experiences discomfort during knee flexion. In those situations, the reverse Lachman test may be useful. According to Rubenstein et al. In the year 1994, the reverse Lachman test has a sensitivity of 63% and a specificity of 89%. For this reason, it has a moderate clinical value to confirm a PCL tear, although we have found only one study to evaluate its validity yet. To perform the reverse Lachman test, have your patient in supine lying position with the knee flexed to 30 degrees. You can stabilize this position by placing your knee under it. Then place your contralateral hand on the femur from lateral and your ipsilateral hand on the tibia from medial, like in a normal Lachman test. Both hands are close to the joint line as we want to translate and not angulate. The tibia must be anatomically reduced in the PCL deficient knee at the start of this test. Rotation is in neutral to avoid the recruitment of secondary stabilizers. Then exert a posteriorly directed force to the tibia and feel for end feel and the degrees of translation. This test is positive if the end feel is soft or absent, or with increased posterior translation of the tibia compared to the other side. Lubowitz et al. Describe a grading for the posterior translation, which is grade 1, 0 to 5 mm, and the tibial plateau remains anterior of the femoral condyle, grade 2, 6 to 10 mm, which correlates with the tibial plateau being flush with the femoral condyle, and grade 3, more than 10 mm of translation, which allows the tibial plateau to translate posterior to the femoral condyle. If you note increased translation with the reverse Lachman test, but not with the posterior drawout test, an injury to the posterior lateral corner might be present. To distinguish between a PLC and a PCL injury, check out our video on the dial test right next to me. All right, this was our video on the reverse Lachman test. I hope this video is helpful to you and you give this video a like. Please hit that subscribe button if you like our channel and check us out on Instagram and Facebook, or visit us on physiotutors.com for more content. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.